We waste too much money in this country. We waste too much time. I just think 2 hours a day should be enough to survive and survive
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely.
2 hours a day.
But it's these guys up here, the Donald Trumps or whatever, that think they have to have the world in their hand that are screwing it around for everybody else.
I mean, if you could do away with all the money we throw around in other countries, right? Do away with money that we house criminals, right?
Right.
I don't want to house criminals. We don't need prisons. I don't think we need prisons. You commit a felony, you die. You commit 3 or 4 misdemeanors, you die, right? You're just a public nuisance. We used to do this 200 years ago when we started this country, right? We used to do it with children.
Yeah,
I'm not going to house you. And no more bailout, savings and loans, bailouts, right?
Yeah, there you go.
No more savings and loans. If we could do away with all this wasteful spending, do away with these congressional staffs, right?
Right,
all
absolutely.
All this money I'm being taxed for just something, they're ripping me off, right?
Absolutely.
If we could do away with all that, right now we're already talking decreasing my 40-hour work week to 30 hours. There must be other ways we can find to decrease 30 to 20.
Sure, well,
and
everybody's got to be in agreement.
Same life, right.
Everybody has to say, okay, this is the plan.
All right. But, Kevin, let me tell you something. Everybody does agree. You agree. Now, do you have a problem with taking a felon, a convicted felon, and blowing him away? Do you have a problem with that?
Oh, I go back and forth on that one.
Okay. I think the majority of people are saying, I am not a felon. I will never commit a felony. So we all agree on a lot of things. We just can't put it together.
Absolutely.
We just can't put it together. But there's enormous ways out there to save us money and to make it where I only have to work 10 hours a week.
Absolutely.
I want to live life. I don't want to live to work. I don't want to work to live.
No, we need to sit on that island, suck on those coconuts.
The shacks are built. Let's eat some coconuts and make out with Marianne. That's what life's
absolutely.
All about.
Absolutely. Well, maybe if we can get over these little problems, we can make it work.
That's right. See you later.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
All right, man. Let's go to Bill in Buford. You're on AM 750 WSB.
Hey, Dave Paul.
Hey, Bill.
How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
Yeah, sounds like it.
Yeah.
I think you're on the right track here.
Okay.
You know what we need is all these radio announcers and broadcasters. They got the power to help us.
Right.
Us little people. And you're on the right track there. I've worked for 35 years. I've helped a health problem. They just set me back.
Yeah.
They don't even want to do nothing for me.
Yeah, of course not.
No, they put me
you
in
paid
a hole.
In. You paid in all your life, but tough.
Yeah, really.
Tough, Bill.
That's what I say.
Here's the shaft. We got your money. I mean, you know.
Yeah.
You're just in the way now, right?
That's what the government told me.
Yeah, if you're not producing income and paying taxes, get out of the way.
That's right.
That's right, Bill.
That's a fact.
That's right.
Maybe you guys can help us.
10 hours a week.
I think you can help us.
See you later, Bill.
Okay, thank you.
Bye. Hey, Bill, this is real. I'm telling you. This is the United States of America. We've got the roads built. You know, we've got to put up a new railing now and then, but the road is already there, right? We've got to... welfare? Screw you, man. Screw you. You ain't going to work, you ain't going to eat, all right? I don't care if you lay on the street or not. Screw you. Food stamps, your mama, right? Take your mama. You know, all right? Give me a break. Go out and eat some grass in the front yard. I'm not going to pay for it anymore. 10 hours a week is what I'm going to contribute, and I want everything. Right? Savings and loan? Give me a break. I'm not bailing anybody out. I don't care if you go under or not. Right? You get it? Right? Right? Congressional staff, right. Forget it. 10 hours a week. And we could have it all. Let's go to Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Mickey and Palmetto, you're on AM 750 WSB.
David, what you're talking about is an authority license for everybody, I believe.
What are you talking about?
Authority where everybody can be an authority, like doctors, lawyers, policemen, politicians.
How is everybody an authority?
Well, everybody would dominate their own life, and everybody would contribute their own part to it.
That's right.
And
no, you'd still work for you could still work for somebody else. Majority of people would, but you'd only work 10 hours a week, and they'd have to hire a lot more people to work there.
Well, the way I got
a lot more people be unemployed.
The way I got it figured out, everybody could think maybe a minute or two a week, and decide what they wanted, and go out and say, I got the authority to take care of my life and do it myself. Wouldn't that work?
Yeah, it would, but you don't. You're a prisoner to this system. You're an economic prisoner.
That's why
you're an economic. This country has been made up to control you, to own you, to possess you from the minute you're born until the minute you die. That's why we got satellites in space. We got so we can keep an eye on you. Okay, it's just they're computerized. Your name's in a computer. Everything about you. You are a controlled piece of meat.
Well, what I want.
All right, I want to take control back, and I want to live a life rather than working all my life.
What I want to tell you is issue a license, David.
Yeah.
You issue a license for everybody to be authority of their own body and to take care of their own life, and we'll...
That's exactly what I want.
We'll back you up, and we'll get donations in for you.
All right, thanks.
And you run it.
Donation. All right, I will. I'll be king. If you want to set me up as king, I'll set it. You know, we need a king. See you later,
well,
Mickey.
Well, you got to have one.
We do. You're right. See you later, Mickey. You know why we need a king? And I hate to say it. You know, we need a 10-hour work week, but we need a just king. The reason we need a just king is everybody, you know, like these death penalties for felons and stuff like that. Everybody out there, we could have a vote, and 90% of you say, yeah, I don't commit felonies, and it'd save us a whole lot of money. I wouldn't have to pay taxes on it anymore. Yeah, I agree. But then you'd have these goody-two-shoes up there, and they'd say, well, I have a problem. It says right here in Scripture. You know, and this would, you know, give me a break. We need a king that says, all right, fine, you die. It's real simple. You die. It's not up for negotiation, not up for discussion, right? And it's just, that's why we need a just king. We'd have a great society, but back to the phones. 10-hour work week. Live like Marianne, or live like Gilligan. Ron, on a car phone, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Dave, this is the craziest thing you've ever came up with, pal.
What do you mean?
You know it wouldn't work.
You
can talk about it.
I know
it
wouldn't.
You can idealize about it, but you know and I know you can't do that. People work more now because they want more.
That is not true.
It is true.
No, you work more to survive. The reason people work 80 hours a week for a family rather than 40 like it used to be is because they have no choice in the matter. They have no say.
That is not true. Everybody has a choice, Dave.
My dad had more for 40 hours than couples now have with 80 hours.
Everybody has a choice as to what they want to do.
Oh, my gosh, what choice do you have?
And how many hours they want to work.
That's not
what
true.
What you're talking about, Dave, what you're talking about, is putting everybody's wants and desires on the same level. You
mm-hmm.
can't do that with human beings. Everybody wants different things. Some people don't want to work now. They get welfare, they get food stamps, and they don't work.
Ron, they don't have to work because you give them money regardless if they work or not.
Okay, but
you call it welfare and everything, and you have no problem with it.
I have a problem with it, Dave.
Yeah.
But you cannot put everybody's level of industriousness on the same level, pal. Come on, be real.
Why can't I?
I mean, you're pretty wacky, but you know.
Ask me this. If we could decrease taxes by 50%,
mm-hmm.
okay? Now, by decreasing taxes, that means I don't have to quite make as much money to survive, right?
That's right.
Does that mean that you can decrease my hours from 40 to 35?
Who would want to, Dave?
No, but
who would want to?
Theoretically, couldn't you do that?
You could do that, Dave,
right,
but nobody would want to do that. Everybody wants to make more money, Dave.
Well, you have the choice of working a couple jobs then, I guess. But what you're saying is you could find ways to have exactly what you have right now and work less hours.
I mean, what do you drive, 68 Volkswagen?
Yeah, close to it.
Okay. I mean, wouldn't you like to drive a Mercedes? Sure you would.
Would I?
Wouldn't you like to drive a BMW?
If somebody gives me one, I'll drive it. But I'm not going to be a prisoner to a car payment.
Dave.
What?
You're talking about putting everybody on the same social economic level.
No, I'm not.
It'll never happen.
No, I'm not.
About it. It's a good subject.
Right.
It's intrigued a lot of people. Most of these people calling you up probably are the bums that are on welfare anyway.
That is not true. Are you a bum?
No, sir.
And are you a welfare?
Nope.
Well, somebody could say that in three calls, and I'll have to argue because I knew
people,
you're not.
You've got people calling you, though,
right.
and agreeing with you.
It's because I'm correct.
What is their IQ, Dave?
No,
their IQ's got to be awful small because it can't work.
You've got no vision, man. You believe if it exists when I was born, it should exist throughout my life, and you couldn't change anything.
It's nice to talk about, but it's a fantasy. I believe that we should get lower the taxes.
Do you not agree?
I think the government should put money back in our pocket.
Do you not agree, Ron? Do you not agree? Do you agree with this? You've got to agree with this, that in my dad's generation, it took 40 hours to get a house, a car, and pay the bills. It took 40 hours. Now, to have exactly what my dad has, it takes a husband and a wife to work, or it takes 80 hours. It went from 40 to 80. Do you agree with that?
Somewhat, yes.
Okay, somewhat. That's true.
But
so why does it have to work to the negative? Why couldn't it work to the positive? Why couldn't it have gone from 40 to 20?
But see, the same.
Other than poor management, and we have congressmen who are blowing all our money.
It could have if
you're
people,
right, it
if
could
people
have.
Didn't want more.
Right.
But instead, the longer that society goes on, the more we want, Dave. That, you know, back when my dad and probably your dad's time, because you're probably about the same age as I am, see, our mothers did not work.
Right.
Most of the other
women, they didn't have to.
That's right. Most of the other women in the neighborhood didn't work either.
No vision, Ron. You got no vision, Ron. No vision, man.
You're living in a fantasy
world. I'm not in a fantasy world. I'm a positive thinker here, Ron. I think positively.
You're in a fantasy.
Potato salad on the table, and I reap a lot of other foods, all right? I reap enormous benefits by a lousy bowl of potato salad. The same concept can work in life. I put in 2 hours a day, and I get 48 hours back from that 2 hours work.
You're talking about killing people's industriousness.
No, I'm not. I'm talking about, we don't, see you later, Ron.
Bye, Dave.
Bye. David Paul, AM 750, WSB.
I want to work.
I work because I have to work. I want to party. I want to sit down. I want to relax, sit around with a group of people, just party, 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 party. That is the way I want my life to be. I work because I have to. Industrious. Not at all. Not me at all. Kirk Mellish, can you tell me about the weather?
Yeah, Dave. Clear, breezy, and cool this afternoon. High 51. Tonight's low around 32. Mostly sunny and warmer tomorrow. High around 60. Low around 35. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
We don't have to work 40 hours a week. We work 40 hours a week because that's the way our government has set it up. That's the way past generations have set it up. They've moved it from 40 to 80, and you don't even complain about it. I want to move it from 40 to 10. And I know with proper management that we would hire, God, eliminate Congress. I like it. Why don't we have the third branch of government, us? We don't need Congress. The third branch of government be you and I. We sit at home, and we get our little box, and we vote on the issues, and then it goes to the Senate, and then it goes to the president, and he could veto it. But we all sit at home, and you and I just vote. I mean, right there, we save billions and billions of dollars. There we go. Now we save billions and billions. We pay 50% less in taxes, right? My gosh, I've moved from 40 to 30 hours right there. Matt, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Dave.
Matt.
Hey.
What's going on?
You got a pretty good deal going here, Dave, but you need to think about something deeper than what you've been talking about. You said it a while ago, but you laughed it off.
What was that?
Going bankrupt.
I agree. Go bankrupt.
Bankrupt the country. Look at all this debt that we have that they're borrowing money to pay debt on.
I don't even know who we owe the debt to.
That's right.
They say the national debt. I mean, come on, give me a list on television or list in the papers. I want to see all the debts.
All we got to do is just declare bankruptcy. Start over like a woman does when she gets divorced and gets a new name, gets a new line of credit.
That's right.
Change the name of the country and start all over next year.
Screw the debt. What are you going to do, Japan? You know, what are you going to do?
Well, we'd have bad credit for 7 years. We couldn't buy no Japanese TVs or Japanese cars or, you know, all that stuff that we don't need anyway.
Right. Yeah, buy American. You know,
that's
buy
right.
American.
We'd
you
have to
you
live
work
on,
two we, hours a day, put up borders everywhere, just say get lost.
We'd have to live on our own for 7 years.
Yeah, get lost, foreign countries. I'm not interested. You know, build your own country. Do your own thing. I'm not interested.
Great.
Right? It's like, you know, right. You're bringing me down. You're bringing my people down. I'm having to work too much to support these stinking countries, right?
Well, we could do a reorganization. We could get rid of what we didn't want, like welfare and food stamps and things.
Criminals.
Criminals, things that we don't need.
Would you have a problem taking a felon and blowing him away? Would you lose any sleep over that?
I'm kind of like that other guy. There's good and bad in that.
Yeah,
you
got a conscience.
What about the innocent guy that you might kill? You know?
What about the innocent guy, right? Give me a break. I mean, it's not going to happen. I have faith in our American judicial system. Other than that, they're too lenient, I guess. But I have faith that we can, a jury of his peers can convict the right man. Right? I have faith in him. And believing in that would give me the power that I would need to blow him away. All right?
All right.
All right. See you later, Matt.
Take it easy.
Bye, Matt. Heck yes. I feel good, man. I feel real good. 10-hour work week. It could happen. Need to go to the phones. And let's talk to Ed. Hey, Ed, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hi, Dave.
Hey, Ed.
Hey, I'm listening to you. I'm with you. I just want to make sure we're covering all our bases.
Okay.
See, I'm not sure that 2 hours a day is going to be enough. I'm not saying I like working eight, but two might not be enough, and this is why I think that. Me and you were workers, and you're just talking about the workforce, but how about, like, the little kids that can't work and the elderly, they can't work? We might have to work 3 or 4 hours a day to make up for them.
Why can't the elderly work? I mean, you say at 65, retire and sit on your butt and everything and just, you know, wait till you keel over, I guess, right? But why can't somebody, a 60-year-old, do something to contribute to society if we all work 2 hours a day? Why can't they? I mean, why can't something that's not too difficult, something that's just whatever they choose to do? I mean, collect grocery carts at a grocery store. I don't care. But why can't they do something? Why can't everybody do something?
Well, some of those people are going to be able to do some things, mm-hmm. but there are some people. I mean, there's infants that can't do anything.
Who can't do anything?
An infant.
Who wants an infant to do anything?
That's right. So, I mean, who's going to pull the weight for that infant? Somebody has.
The mother will. The father will.
2 hours a day is not going to be enough for her. She might have to work 3 hours a day. Right?
I guess so.
I don't know.
We just got to get this thing going.
That's right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
You agree?
I agree.
10 hours a week.
Well,
2 hours a day.
I agree that we got to figure out a way at less than 40.
Do you agree it could work?
Less than 40.
Do you agree it could work?
I hope so. I want it.
You'd like to see it.
That's right.
And forget about your job when you're through. You work your 10 to 12 shift, your 8 to 12 shift, your 6 in the morning till 8 a.m. shift. Then you're through for the whole day. You forget about it. You don't talk about it with your friends. You get on with your life.
That's right.
You are more than your job.
That's right.
Right? You don't take on the personality of your job. Right?
That's right.
You're an independent person. You're not the job. The job is a job. That's all it is. Right?
That's right. You're just providing a service.
You're doing your barter. That's what you do. And so everybody else does it for you. You do it for them. Right?
That's right. And I'm doing that right now.
See you later.
Okay.
All right, man. We'll see you around. Let's go to Paul. All right, hold on. Let's go to Paul. Hey, Paul, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hey, Dave. How you doing?
Hey, I'm doing good.
I think that individuals that are receiving a government check, whether it be unemployment, workman's comp, or anything like that, they need to be working also.
Of course they do.
They shouldn't be getting a free check.
Of course not.
If you get food stamps, you should be giving something back to the community for getting these food stamps, whether it's sorting mail at the post office for the people that can't walk or lift things heavy, or, building a road over here and filling in potholes, but they should be doing something.
Of course they should. They shouldn't be taking money I'm working hard to get.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm working, you're working, right? You're a working man.
That's right.
Right? But see, right off the top of your check, I mean, they take out money and they just give to these people. Here it is, sit on your fat butts, you lazy, stinking scum, and suck America dry, you loser.
Well, it's,
right?
And
that's not what, I can't stand, that's sick.
It's scary when we're approaching 50% of the population that's getting some form of a government check.
But see,
we're approaching 50%.
Unless government has a plan there to balance out America, right? To balance out the economy and balance it out, they intentionally do that. They intentionally have to keep so many unemployed people to make it where people are begging for a job. Right?
That's what's happening.
To keep the wages down. Because I'm telling you, if you're the only person looking for a job, you can barter. You have something to negotiate with, right?
Right.
If you're the only person. But if 50 people are walking in there applying for a job, they can offer you a minimum pay. Right?
That's true.
And so the way they do that is they keep 10% of the people unemployed. Right?
That's about what it's at, too.
See you later, Paul.
Bye.
Bye. Dave Paul, AM 750 WSB.
That's great. It starts with an earthquake, birds and snakes and aeroplanes. is Clark Howard. Keep listening for your chance to share your good fortune with the AM 750 WSB Christmas Kids. And happy holidays.
WSB Atlanta.
AM 750 WSB, News Time of the Tone, 3 o'clock.
Good afternoon, I'm Mike Cavanaugh on the AM 750 WSB News Center. The temperature at 3 o'clock, 47 degrees. Today's weather clear, breezy, cool. The high about 50. A man who used to wear the robe of the Ku Klux Klan is running for president. But AM 750 WSB's Kerry Browning at the state capitol reports as of right now, David Duke is not going to be on the primary ballot in Georgia.
The three members of the committee, Chairman Alex Poinovet, House Minority Leader Paul Hurd, and Senate Minority Leader Tom Phillips, voted unanimously to take Duke off the Republican ballot in Georgia's presidential primary. Alex Poinovet.
We're not dealing with someone's member of our party and someone whose philosophy was not in concert with the beliefs, particularly of what we're doing here in Georgia. So we've elected to follow the code and practice on the concepts of law set up here in Georgia.
This is not the last round. Duke can petition to have his name put back on the ballot at another meeting of the Democratic and Republican committees that is set for January 8th. If one Republican votes for it, the name goes back on. Right now, it appears the national Republican leaders have said keep Duke off, and that is what's happening in Georgia. From the Capitol, Kerry Browning, AM 750 WSB News.
Consumers who paid money to a now-closed chain of Atlanta furniture stores have been trying for weeks to get answers about their money and their furniture. WSB consumer advice expert Clark Howard has been asking the questions. Today, he finally got an answer.
You'll let them pay the balance, and then you'll let them have the goods.
Right. Again, we got to identify that a deposit was taken. It was taken for a specific sofa or a bed or whatever, and that item of furniture came in, and it's there.
Attorney Bob Lackey with Transamerica Commercial Finance, which has seized what's left of Accent's furniture stores. Lackey says problems remain with consumers who paid for furniture that either doesn't exist or which has been set aside with several names on it. The group that represents the nation's mayors says the problems of hunger and homelessness are getting worse in our big cities. Requests for help up 26%. Most of the new requests from families hit hard by the recession. One in six requests have to be denied because there's no money in city budgets. And that group of mayors says the federal government needs to do more to help big cities this winter. AM 750, WSB News Center time, 3:02. Just ahead, good news for people with cancer, plus a traffic report and the weather from Atlanta's only full-time radio meteorologist.
To remind folks about Steak and Ale's $8.95 prime rib special, we had some pretty big ideas. Like having Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday nights declared National Prime Rib Baked Potato and Salad Bar all for just $8.95 nights. Like hiring the barnstorming Beagle Brothers to skywrite I Heart 895 Prime Rib over every major metropolis. Then we thought, hold it. The most popular item on Steak and Ale's menu for just $8.95? Juicy Prime Rib with baked potato and salad bar? Every Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday night? All we have to do is tell people about it. So, if you love prime rib, you'll love the $8.95 prime rib special. And whenever you don't hear the barnstorming Beagle Brothers roaring overhead, think of Steak and Ale, the legend in steak. And make your holidays extra special with Christmas Eve at Steak and Ale, the perfect place for the family to enjoy the holiday together. Spend Christmas Eve with the legend, Steak and Ale.
I forgot to buy a gift for my sister, Holly.
Tis the season to be.
I have to send something to my Aunt Bee.
Don't we now our gay apparel?
I forgot to mail my brother's socks.
It's never too late to send gifts thanks to two-day Priority Mail Service and Express Mail Service, both from the post office. Priority Mail offers two-day delivery of up to £2 for only $2.90. Express Mail offers guaranteed overnight delivery between major markets for as little as $9.95 and even delivers on Christmas Day.
Show the ancient Yuletide carol!
My Uncle Yule and his wife Carol!
Sponsor of the 1992 Olympic Games.
AM 750, WSB News Center time, 3:04. WSB News about your health. Cancer researchers expanding a program to allow more patients access to new treatment. Kenneth Stone Hospital in Cobb is one of four Atlanta area hospitals participating in the Community Clinical Oncology Program. Research Coordinator Gene Young says That program should draw patients from as far north as Cartersville.
A lot of the childhood cancers are now curable because many years ago, 80% of children were put into clinical trials.
Patients will have access to about 90 state-of-the-art cancer treatments or therapies, including some experimental drugs which otherwise are simply not available. Taking the latest pulse of our economy, we have one, but it continues to be weak. The government says industrial production down nearly a half a point last month. It's the fourth month in a row of declines. The country's manufacturing sector continues to be in a slump. Wall Street at this hour, Dow Jones average of 16.77 stands at 29.31. AM 750, WSB News Center, time 3:05. Now, a live update from the WSB Skycopter and Skyplane Traffic Center.
I-75 southbound out of Cobb County. Between 285 and the Chattahoochee River, watch for authorities handling a brush fire in that area, especially in the right lanes. You're going to find some spectator slowing. Georgia 400 northbound around the Pitts Road overpass. Watch out for a big roll of insulation blocking up your center lane. We appreciate the listener tip on the Bell South Mobility Hotline about that. Cobb County going to a new wreck now. South Cobb Drive at Benson Pool. Downtown, watch out for a wreck involving a tractor trailer on North Highland Road near Virginia Avenue. And down in Clayton County, police responding to a wreck involving a school bus now. No report of any injuries yet, though. The 5800 block of Riverdale Road. Watch out in that area. Chris Monroe in the AM 750 WSB Traffic Center.
The time, 3:06. WSB Skycopter and Skyplane Traffic helps you save time this afternoon with Gary McKee. Hear a report every 6 minutes, only on AM 750 WSB. Now, Atlanta's most accurate weather with WSB meteorologist Kirk Mellish.
My exclusive five-day forecast. This afternoon, clear, breezy, and cool, high 51. Clear and cold tonight, lows around 32. Tomorrow, mostly sunny and warmer, high around 61, low around 35. The extended forecast, Wednesday through Friday, partly sunny, highs Wednesday 50, low 30. Friday, high 58, low 39. Recapping the forecast for this afternoon, breezy, cool, and clear, a high of 51. I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
Currently, WSB color radar is clear. The skies are sunny. Relative humidity, 17%. Winds northwest now at 12 miles an hour. And the barometric pressure falling all afternoon now at 30.40. At 3:07, the temperature on Peachtree Street, 47 degrees. Out to Lunch with David Paul continues now. I'm Mike Cavanaugh, and if news breaks out, we'll break in. This is Atlanta's news, weather, and traffic station. AM 750, WSB, depend on it.
Oh, no! It's Out to Lunch with David Paul. Afternoons will never be the same. The phone number to go on the air is 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Now, AM 750 WSB presents David Paul.
Oh, hello, darling.
You've come for a wash, cut, and tease. So sit down in my chair, please. There's no one better than moi with scissors and a comb. Just turn me loose with my gel and my mousse. Oh, yes! Till that hairdo's perfect, darling, I won't let you go home. Oh, no! I'll tint, frost, or even dye, but I really love to blow dry. And I'm the best when your head gets overgrown. Then I use hairspray to make your hair stay.
Oh, yes! Till that hairdo's perfect, darling, I won't let you go home. But now I'm getting upset, and I'm working up a little sweat. I tried a new style, but on you it just looks all wrong. I need a little more time, and I'll tell you why. Just die, 'cause your hair's the worst mess I've ever worked on.
Call back. Work. Y'all realize, now I hope you realize this. You need to. That this is our time on the planet Earth. Everybody that existed before us is dead. They are buried. They are dust. They are no more than a memory in some book. They don't exist. We don't have to follow their traditions. That we don't have to follow their plans. We can ignore them. We can do anything we want to do. This is our time. We can do whatever our creative mind comes up with. And I just think that just we've built a great place to live. Our past generations have built us a great place to live. We're abusing it real bad. I mean, we're abusing it big time. We are. I mean, we're the most destructive generations ever come along. We've got to change that somehow, but that's our management. We got lousy management. Let's corporate America just do anything they want to do. And, yeah, I mean, really sucks, man. Big time what disgusting people we've turned into, but I don't want to get into that. But we waste so much time, and we waste so much money. There's no reason we can't slowly start decreasing our work week. You build a house. The house is built. You don't have to spend as much time anymore building the house. It's built. You've got all that time. Now you can play in the house. Now just a couple hours a day, you've got to vacuum and wash the dishes, right? Now and then you might have to paint a wall. That's the way this country is. It's time to sit back and relax. It's time to develop a system that you only have to contribute 10 hours a week. It's like somebody said on Gilligan's Island. I love that analogy. The shack is built. Now it's time to sit back and eat a coconut and make out with Marianne. That's what it's all about. 40 hours a week is slave labor. They own you. You're a piece of property. You could have the same benefits in life, the same luxuries, by working 10 hours a week if we set the system up accordingly. And it could be done. There's no reason it could. No reason. If we got rid of all wasteful spending, gave you 90% of your tax dollars back. My gosh. You go to a picnic. You take your potato salad. You put it on the table. Now, after I put my potato salad on the table, I get a paper plate and I get to go dip into your baked beans, your ribs, your fruit salad, your cornbread, all from just my little contribution of potato salad. Do you see how it works? I put in 2 hours a day, and I should have 100 hours of man time coming back at me. I've given you 2 hours, right? It's just that's the way it works. I love it. I feel good about it. I'm excited about it. Billy, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hey, David.
Billy.
In regards to what you've just said, there's people that's getting a free ride.
No kidding.
That are not working.
No.
40 hours a week, and there's people like me and probably you that's working 40 hours a week, and then maybe some more than 40 hours a week that are getting the same thing that these people that don't work are going to be getting.
I know that. We all know that, Billy.
A prime example is... My grandmother's in a nursing home right now.
Right.
And she's worked all of her life.
Right.
And she had a substantial savings.
Sure.
And right now she has to be in a nursing home. But in order to get her in a nursing home, she couldn't have any money.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we had to pay up front until we depleted her whole banking account. Pay the nursing home $70 a day.
Mm.
And when we finally get that down, then she can get Medicaid.
Hmm.
On the same hand, there's people in the nursing home that did not have one dime when they went in that nursing home that's getting the same amount of treatment that my grandmother's getting today.
Right.
And it didn't cost them a dime.
Thanks a lot, Billy.
Okie doke.
See you, Billy. A lot of times, people on welfare, see, they can't help it. I mean, they're just lazy people, as lazy, good-for-nothing people. But the government encourages people on welfare. Why do they encourage people on welfare? It balances out the system. It balances out. It keeps wages low. And it's a tool to use against you, okay? It is a tool, and it works very effectively, okay? It keeps wages down. It does. It works great. It works great. It takes money out of your pocket so you don't have too much money to spend. And you're an economic prisoner. Your wife's an economic prisoner, all right? Do you understand how it works, man? It's sick. Let's go to Carl in downtown. You're on AM 750 WSB.
Dave, Paul, how you doing?
Good, Carl.
Are we having fun yet, brother?
We're having a blast, Carl.
You know, I got a question for you.
10 hours a week, man. 10 hours a week.
10 hours a week? You're crazy.
That's all I want.
Man, you've got more empty space between your ears than the congressional leadership has active brain cells.
Yeah,
hey,
what?
I remember you're building the house analogy.
Right.
You build the house.
It's
you're
built.
You're there. You go back. You
right.
watch Gilligan's Island.
Right.
You see the skipper in his hat. You go make out with Marianne.
Right.
The point of reference is, after you build the house,
mm-hmm.
you maintain
the house.
The house.
But it doesn't take 40 hours like it did originally to build the house.
Right, but it still can take the same amount of dedication depending on the appearance and the heart that you want to put into that house.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it can take 10 hours.
You know, the way I look at it is you build a house, right? I've built a business, all right? I've built a business. The business exists.
Right.
Now I'm putting in a lot of man hours, and I should be reaping back enormous profits, but I'm not. There never seems to be enough money for anybody. Something is wrong. You know what I mean, Carl? The business, you go out, I build a business, or I build a house, okay? I've built the house exists.
Right.
Now I go out and I continually work the 40 hours that originally I was working to build the house.
Right.
But now I'm working 40 hours to put nice furniture in there.
Exactly.
I should live in a palace. I should live with chandeliers hanging from every ceiling. Right?
Hey, with the salary that you make up there doing what you're doing, you probably do have chandeliers.
I'm just telling you what should exist, Carl, and it does not exist. It does not exist. Something is wrong. You and I are being controlled from an outside force we're unaware of, and every day of our life is. We do not need to work 40 hours to survive. 10 hours is all we need to work.
Wrong.
It's not wrong.
Because think about it like this. Grant the fact that major labor has been done in completion of the house.
Right.
You are still having to transfer the hours that you used building the house into maintaining the house and keeping it in a presentable atmosphere.
Not true.
And as far as the work is concerned,
not true.
How much time,
all right,
in your own life,
all right,
how much time do you spend on your show preparation before you go on the air?
10 minutes.
10 minutes max.
Mm-hmm.
It shows. Sometimes it shows. I've listened to you for a long time,
right,
brother,
okay,
especially on overnights. And I have to be honest, man, I think you kind of lost a little bit of a step in the time change going from overnight to afternoon.
You do. Well, thank you, Carl, but that's not the discussion today, Carl. It's not report card day for David Paul. That's not what it's all about. Maybe we'll do that one afternoon. It's a good idea. Write that down, Melanie. Write that down. Report card day for David Paul. You write that down? Yeah, we'll do that 1 hour report card time. Yeah, that sounds like fun. Yeah, good chance to slam me. Yeah, thanks a lot. No, I don't agree with that at all. The shack is built. Why do I need to go out and continually go out and pick up bamboo and put in the same amount of time? I don't have to. Now it's time to sit back in the shade in the shack I've built and make out with Marianne and eat coconuts. All I should have to do is go out and get my fishing pole and catch a fish for supper. That is what, and I still have that shack every day. I have the same comfort that when I built the house. 10 hours a week max. We could have the exact same lifestyle. Open your minds. David Paul, AM 750 WSB.
Atlanta's Morning News with Scott Slade and the AM 750 WSB News Team. Start each day with news, weather, and...
Hey, Dave, come on, I'll do it. Rum, rum, like there you go. Oh, there you go. Rum,
duh.
Rum. Hometown Radio Show this afternoon with Gary McKee. Listen and call us and tell us your biggest holiday gripe. 4 to 7 this afternoon. Now more from Dave Paul on Atlanta's News, Weather, and Traffic Station, AM 750 WSB.
Great stuff, man. Great stuff. All right, yeah, Kirk Mellish, can you tell me about the weather?
Clear sky, breezy and cool, high 51. Clear and cold tonight, low around 32. Tomorrow, mostly sunny and warmer, high near 60, low 35. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
Yeah. David Paul. The work we do. Go to the phones right now and let's talk to Mark. Hey, Mark.
David Paul.
Mark.
This is absolutely disgusting.
What is, Mark?
What are you trying to attempt to piece together on the radio today?
Now, Mark, what I'm trying to piece together is we're wasting a lot of time, and I could have the same benefits I have today by working only 10 hours a week if we were properly managed.
See, who can manage 10 hours a week? From what I've heard of the show, you've described two things.
Yeah.
You've described Thanksgiving dinner. Have you related it to that at all?
No, I have not.
Where somebody gets together and they bring their potato salad.
That's right.
Uncle Joe brings his turkey.
That's true. Thanksgiving dinner. It's just like Thanksgiving dinner.
Well, you know what that means?
What?
You got a bunch of slobs over at your house. That's what happens. Everybody in this country wants to be on their own.
Right.
And if I got to make a turkey and that's all, and I got to depend on somebody else to bring a potato salad, and it's always going to be the fat aunt nobody likes, and she's going to come over and sit in my hut for 3 hours, that's not going to work. And I have to work. Hey, this is sick. And you've also, I think I've pieced this together with another thing.
Right.
This is Haiti, the island of Haiti.
Right.
That's what you've done. Hey, let's all get together, let's work a couple hours a week, and screw Mary Ann. And then what happens about 10 years down the road? The island's infested with AIDS, and nobody, I mean, nobody will get near them. Isn't that what you've described, Dave?
That's pretty much it, Mark.
Don't you go to a library and research these topics at all, Dave? This is disgusting. You people out there,
you're a sheep of society. Unless somebody else told you how to do it, you don't know how to do it. You're incapable of coming up with an original thought, Mark. You think you're stuck in a rut?
No, this is what I am.
What?
I have somebody that sits in a throne and looks down at people like you. You struggle to understand what this planet's all about.
Yeah.
You sit here. And you're saying that we're being controlled by an outside force.
That's right.
Well, man, is that a brain surgeon statement. Are you kidding, Dave? Of course we are. If you didn't have someone holding your hand, we'd have clotheslines on our houses. We'd have dirt roads and screen doors with locks on them. You people have to have somebody to hold your hand. If you didn't, this place would go straight to hell.
Mark,
and you don't even care, do you?
Mark, no, I do care, and you're exactly right. Government is holding our hand.
They have to.
No, they're doing more than holding. They're deceiving us.
No, they're not.
Unemployment is a scam. It's all set up. Welfare is a scam. It's all a scam. How do you know how many people are on welfare? How do you know?
How do you know
how many people are on welfare? You don't know.
Dave,
they say 20 million people are on welfare, but how do you not know that it's 3 million and they pocket the rest of the money or they build other countries with it? You don't know.
See,
the
Dave,
whole thing's a scam.
No, that's what I mean by me sitting in the chair looking at you struggling. This is what I know, Dave.
Why?
The government, as high as the unemployment ever is, is close to 10%. I know that 2 out of 3 people are stupid. I think that's a hell of a ratio. And you're going to sit here and start complaining about people that aren't working. Well, Dave, half the people on this planet walk into walls with no apparent warning. They put on shoes that don't match your clothes. How do they get jobs? We have to have somebody to lead these people through their life. Or we'd have to pay for them living on the street.
Mark, I agree. We need proper management, and that's why we hire government leaders to manage the country and keep us on the right direction. We hire these guys. They're employees of ours. We need management. I agree with that. But
you're
I don't feel like
state.
I have to work 40 hours a week. 10 hours a week is the maximum I should have to work to benefit. Just like putting the potato salad on the table during Thanksgiving. I get a whole meal just by putting lousy potato salad on the meal.
You're a socialist is what you're describing. So you need to just move to the Soviet Union, and that way you can work 2 hours a week and sponge off everybody else. That's what you want, right?
I'm a socialist.
That's exactly what you're describing.
You don't think there are a lot of socialist things going on in this country right now? Welfare, you don't think that's socialism?
Dave, I think welfare...
You don't think welfare is socialism? I mean, come on, what do you think it is?
Welfare is to keep you where you are.
To keep me where I am.
Right.
And I think it does a good job.
The government gives these people these checks to keep them there.
All right. See you later, Mark.
See ya.
Bye, Mark. Kathy, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Kathy.
Yeah, I like the two-day workday thing.
You do?
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, 10-hour days.
I mean
10 hours a week.
And it was so funny because my girlfriend and I were talking like 3 weeks ago. I said, you know, 2 days is not enough. And so we had half it down to work just like 3 days a week.
Right.
And now the rest of the time off, we thought that could work. The cure sounds better. But anyway, so what I thought about the little national debt that's floating around.
Right.
Now the government just say whoever's in charge of the treasury say we're in debt of what a gazillion dollars whatever.
Right.
Go and make that amount of money.
I agree. Just write a check.
Just make the money.
We make the money.
And then just pay it.
You're right. Just write them a check.
Yes.
Start the printing presses and keep them running.
And then it's over with.
That simple as that.
Hey,
you're right.
Go
See,
and make make a little extra that day.
Thanks a lot, Kathy. You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. Daggum, Julie in Conyers, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hi, David.
Hey, Julie.
Hi. I called to talk about what you're talking about. I agree with you 100%.
10-hour work weeks, and you could have the exact same thing you already have right now if we are properly managed.
That's exactly right, and we're not properly managed at all.
No, we're not.
Do you know who qualifies for welfare?
Who?
Those who want to sit home and don't want to work.
But see, I don't think, I think welfare people are the laziest group. If you can't do it, make it in this country, you are the ultimate world loser.
That's right.
I mean, you have people in other countries who have one-tenth of what we have in advantages, right?
Right.
And if you can't find something in this country and you're on welfare, you are the biggest loser on the planet Earth.
That's
when you're, we're talking losers, you are at the bottom of the entire globe because you've got every opportunity in front of you. You are just, you are the lowest life form if you are an American and you're on welfare. Because other countries, these people are starving. They have a hard time. They make it somehow, right?
That's right.
And you got everything right here, and you can't make it? Man, you are scum.
Well, you know that.
You are scum.
You might have to use your brain a little bit.
Yeah, you might have to. But no, I don't think. I think they're just, man, they're lazy scum.
Yeah, they are.
But no, if we got proper management that we would hire, you and I would not have to work more than 10 hours a week.
And that's the way it ought to be.
And have every luxury you have right now.
Yeah,
10 hours a week.
You're exactly right.
See you later, Julie.
All right, thanks.
Bye. Because we waste 30 hours a week for big business, for big brother, for government. We waste it. David Paul, AM 750 WSB.
Hi, this is Chris Monroe from the AM 750 WSB Skycopter and Skyplane Traffic Center, hoping you make this a happy and safe holiday season. Happy holidays from all of us at AM 750 WSB.
Tops and Tales, Atlanta's best adult entertainment club, would like to invite you for a day or evening of great times and is asking your help in giving a needy child a good Christmas. From now through Christmas Eve, bring a new package toy to Tops and Tales at 1888 Cheshire Bridge Road and get in free. All toys collected will be distributed to children right here in Atlanta. Tops and Tales is, of course, proud of our club. We've worked hard to bring you one of the proud to be a part of this great city. We're asking your help in giving the children of Atlanta a happy Christmas memory. And in exchange, we'll give you free admission to Tops and Tails. Bring your new package toy to Tops and Tails, 2 blocks off of Piedmont on Cheshire Bridge Road, or take 85 South to exit 30. Turn left, go 5 traffic lights to Tops and Tails.
But you used to be a nice, decent, honest citizen. You just didn't know what you were getting into, did you? You probably thought you'd be helping your fellow man, defending the laws, the American way. Yeah, right. Well, here at Lawyers Anonymous, we understand what you're going through. We're a group of ex-lawyers who suddenly realized that being a lawyer meant becoming a lying, crooked, money-grubbing scumbag slimeball who's only in it for the cash. Come to one of our meetings. You'll see you're not alone.
And I thought I'd be helping people, you know. Using my schooling to then I found myself raising my fees arbitrarily and stabbing my clients, co-workers in the back, and I just can't stand it.
If life as an attorney just isn't what you expected, call Lawyers Anonymous, a place for scum who just want to be halfway decent again.
We're missing the boat, everybody. We're missing the boat. Life is to be enjoyed. Sit back and party. Prop your feet up. Eat good. Drink. I mean, life is to have a blast. It really is. It's not to be a slave, you know, working 40 hours a week. That is not what life is all about. That is not life. And that's what, you know, the government has made it where just, you know, 40 hours is just not enough anymore for a family to survive. Now you got to have yours plus your wife's 80 hours. 80 hours a week to survive. Next, it'll be 100 hours. You'll have to have your firstborn child out there working to survive. It's getting worse and worse. When really, you could have all the benefits you have right now by working 10 hours a week with proper management of our money. Proper management, 10 hours a week, 2 hours a day. You go out there like right now, you work the 4 to 6 shift. You'll work the 10 in the morning till noon shift. You know, and you could have the exact same benefits by doing your share of the work. It's frustrating, man. It's frustrating. See, I know this could exist. I know it could be out there. But we just don't put it together. We don't want to put it together because we're stuck in a rut called tradition. Eddie, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Yeah, that caller back just a minute ago, Mark, man, he scares the hell out of me.
Why did he scare you?
The ultimate sheep.
The ultimate sheep.
Yeah, I got something here.
Well, he said right here, he said a couple comments were scary. We need guidance.
Yeah, I'm
going
to carry the ball for you on
right,
this.
Okay.
I went to a private school where creativity and discussion was allowed for a while.
Oh, that's rare, yeah,
and
okay.
We debated this very issue you're bringing up about communal effort.
Right.
And what we could do is, let's take 100 people, right? And all these people want the same interest. They all want a house.
Mm-hmm.
So we pitch in. Like, one guy buys all the doors. One guy, like you said, what people don't realize is these people will only pay, say, from 1/100th to 1/90th the price of that home when it's constructed, when everyone's contributing.
Right.
And what's even better, what you could do is, in our present day, you know, things are so slow to change, we could get a parcel of land somewhere, and we could set up an entire community, get a bunch of people who share a common interest,
mm-hmm.
set up our own power source. It would be different from government of today where, you know, everybody just waits and waits for things to change because you all get together and pay at the same time, and boom, it's there. Your power stations are there. Your houses are there. Your farming facilities are there. It's all there right away.
Mm-hmm.
No waiting for years and years and being taxed to death
mm-hmm.
to get this stuff constructed. So, yeah, it's an excellent idea.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. And as long as you work, you get to participate.
And here's a quote.
And as long as you work, you eat, and you have clothes.
Here's something for Mark.
Right.
Here's something for Mark back there. It
all
says,
right.
If you do nothing else but keep your nose to the grindstone and work hard, long hours, you're guaranteed to get only one thing in return, old.
See you later, Eddie. Bye, Eddie. Mary, you're on AM 750 WSB.
I feel just like Mark does.
What is that?
I think you're a bunch of gobbledygook.
Gobbledygook?
Yes.
Why do you say that, Mary?
You're a big liar is what you are.
What?
You don't feel that way at all.
What way do I not feel, Mary?
Well, just you know what you feel like.
I know exactly what I feel like.
Sure you do.
Mm-hmm.
But you're a big bunch of gobbledygook. That's all you are.
Big bunch of gobbledygook. What is gobbledygook?
Well, just a big bunch of nothing.
Big bunch of nothing.
Right.
All right.
And you just, oh, I don't know.
You don't know what, Mary?
I don't know what's going on.
If you don't know what's going on, maybe I can explain it to you.
You don't know what's going on is
I
what
do
I mean.
Too.
You do not.
Right.
You're a big bunch of
gobbledygook.
Gobbledygook is what you are.
Right.
You sure are.
Right. So you don't like the idea of a 10-hour work week.
I don't know how you can figure that. For Pete's sake, you're in a dream world.
Not in a dream world.
You're
I'm in the real world.
You're in a dream world, and I don't know how you can figure that at all.
All right, let me explain to you.
Oh, I don't want it explained to me.
Oh, come on, let me explain to you, Mary. Come on, Mary. This is Mary. Trace that line, Melanie, trace that line. All right, return call. Give her a return call. Call her back. Push, what is that, star? What do you call? Give her a return call. Get Mary back on the line. Gobbledygook.
I just have one question, Dan.
Yeah, what's that?
If you work 2 hours a day, who does the rest of your show?
No. Everybody has two-hour shifts a day, and just bring it. See, it employ more talk show hosts. See, automatically. See, I've taken a talk shows who are out of work, and there are thousands of them, and I've given them jobs. Right? You see how what I've done here? Right? So you'd only be there 2 hours a day, and then you go out and party the rest of the day. You've employed people by bringing them in here and finish up your shift. Isn't that great?
It's great, Dave.
It is great. Thank you, Melanie. It's great. It is really great. Rob, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Dave.
Rob.
I don't know. I'm kind of partial to it in a few ways. I mean, I'd love to be able to take that 2 hour a day, 10 hour a week shift. But
I'm just a gutless wonder, and I like society the way it is, right? And I couldn't stand up and, you know, fight for it because I just don't. I'm nobody, right?
No.
Come on, Rob.
No.
Get a life. Rob,
this
is your time to be on the planet. You don't have to stick to a 100-year-old tradition.
Not necessarily.
Right,
I mean,
what, Rob?
You've got to put in your dues at some point.
My
so
gosh,
go
Rob,
through.
40 hours a week is more than your dues.
Okay.
It's called being a slave. Slave to a society. I don't want to be a slave. I should be able to put in 2 hours, and that's my time. But 40 hours, man, I'm a piece of property. I'm my whole life. You know, to a poor guy like you, Rob, and you should be standing up. You're a guy. Do you realize you're going to work till you drop?
All right, well, let me throw
you know
this
that
at
you. You know that you're going to work till you die. Okay, you will never have a break. You will never, and in your entire life, unless we change it, have a break.
No, that doesn't bother you, Rob. If you do it right early on, it's going to it pays off for you
if
later.
You do
on.
What early on?
If you do it right to the point that you've put in your dues early on, then you can enjoy that 10-hour work week
you
later
can.
On.
You can.
Sure. You put in your time. Sometimes right. It even requires more than that. If it's something that's worth achieving, then you want to put as much time into it as possible.
I am not reaping the rewards that you should reap for working 40 hours a week.
Not yet, but you will.
No,
Dave,
you will.
I'm telling
not
you.
What? When you're too old to enjoy it? You mean when I'm 60 something?
No.
When I got one foot in a lousy grave? Is that what you're talking about, Rob?
Not that far down
my
the road.
Gosh, when I can't even, you know what I mean? I'm on my back. Oh, yeah, hell yeah. Oh, man, it's better. You know, give me a break. I want to enjoy it right now while I can still move.
Not that far down
right,
the road,
right.
Dad.
What?
Not that far down. You keep working hard at what you do, and you're putting in the 40-hour work weeks.
Yeah.
Or beyond getting paid.
Sucker.
It's going to pay off for you sooner than you think. But it's the putting the time into
you
it.
Poor
it would be great
sucker.
To be able to do that.
You
but
poor,
I don't.
Poor.
I just don't see how I could do it.
Yeah, well, I could. No, you can't do it right now. The society won't work up. Won't come up. It won't come up. I mean, it won't work in society. There is no this dues thing. I mean, just give me a break. I'm this United States of America.
How many other problems would stem from?
What do you mean?
I
guarantee you put me in charge. You make me king, and overnight I'll get rid of 50% of your debt problems.
Uh-huh.
I will make it. I mean, utility companies. I'll get rid of the profit motive. I mean, everything out there that you have, I'll get rid of the profit motive because I have to have it. And if I have to have it survive, get rid of the thing of profit motive. Insurance, no profit. I mean, get rid of the profit motive, right? I mean, get rid of the profit and everything that I have to have. And luxury items, put the profit in there. But if I have to have it, get rid of the profit motive. Get rid of the United States Congress because they're a bunch of sick people anyway, right? We don't need a Congress. You can be the Congress, right? You can vote at home. I like that idea somebody came up with earlier. We save money, right? Get rid of foreign spending, right? You agree with that, too?
I agree with that.
Take all criminals out and blow them away,
yeah.
All right? Just take a bullet, the price of a bullet, and we've got rid of housing a criminal, okay? Right? Next thing you know, zap, all the money I saved, I've already decreased your work rate from 40 to 25 hours doing right there.
That's
now
we just find...
Is that true?
That's true. And I'll
then
tell you
where's
what.
The problem, Rob?
Well, I'll tell you what. If,
there's the
if
problem.
We were to
I
take all those,
it.
If we were to take all that
yeah.
into consideration,
yeah,
I really think that would be achievable, and I'd like to see it done. So I guess I'm sort of with your opinion now. You've kind of swayed me in that direction, Dave.
Thanks for the call, Rob.
All righty.
See you, Rob. Tim, you're on AM 750 WSB.
All right. It's funny, like I said, the other guy was on a minute ago was... He said that something came up. I'm a political science major, and we talked about this.
Are you going to be a lawyer?
No.
Then why
no.
are you getting a political science degree? What a piece of garbage degree that is.
Well, that's opinions, I guess.
No, I mean, what are you going to do with it? What are you going to do with it? You're going to be at a party. You could go on Jeopardy or something, I guess.
I'd probably win big money. Would have to work
you
at
could,
all.
Yeah, you go on Jeopardy, but what are you? Unless you go all the way and become a lawyer, what are you going to do with it?
Well... I'm undecided. I got a lot
well, go, you might as well go ahead and become a lawyer because otherwise, political science.
Well, despite the fact we talked about what you're talking about tonight,
yeah.
And I know you said something about being a socialist, and I don't know, somebody said that, and I think in a way you talked about welfare and work, and I think some of the ideas that you have are too radical. I think that if you all of a sudden just change that, things do need to be changed, and I think we can make a compromise.
The formation of this country was a radical idea.
Yeah.
Okay, radical ideas have the highest payoff.
True, but they also have they are prone to the most problems. Look at this country.
You're right, this country, but see, we've created our own problems.
Well, I agree.
Any problem out there is solvable. We just have to be motivated, and we have to have a guy with an original thought to solve the problem.
Well, welfare, let's take, for example, welfare. I don't approve of it, however.
Mm-hmm. I've got a
Pat Buchanan, you know, how he's going to run, he had a couple ideas, and I'm not going to, you know, vote for him because I've already heard a lot of the stuff he said, but he had an idea that I kind of liked. He said people that are on welfare should work for it.
Of course they should, but
see, and they don't. That's wrong.
But see, in the way the system, as many safeguards are out there, the way it's set up, these guys, the president doesn't have any power. He can't do crap, man. Congress will stand in his way, and they'll be bickering. They'll settle with, I mean, they got nothing anymore, man.
Your 10-hour work week, though, Dave, has already been tried.
The simpler the society is, the better it works.
Correct.
Our society is becoming too complicated, and it doesn't work anymore. We can't even take care of our crime problem.
Right, but if you look at your communal system.
This is no joke. I could go to a bank tomorrow, rob it, shoot one of the security guards, right? Shoot them, and then I go, and they let me out. They send me, okay, you got 30 years, but because of prison overcrowding, you get 12 months.
Right.
And that's the way it works. We can't even, we're sick, man. We got to.
What about your 10-hour, what about your 10-hour? It's been tried.
10 hours.
You know it's been tried?
No, it has not been tried.
You know where? Let me
where?
In the 60s, where do you think communals were?
Communals. Okay, right there. Okay, we did it in communals. Sorry I brought it up on the show. You're absolutely right. It's been tried. Yeah, a bunch of hippies, a bunch of stoned out freak hippies did it. Okay, yeah, I apologize. David Paul, AM 750, WSB.
You know, we really hate to do it sometimes, but from time to time, we just have to break right into regular programming to give you the top news first, to get it on fast.
We want to do whatever the imagination comes up with, get out of the rut everybody's in. 40 hours a week is primitive. Kirk Mellish, can you tell me about the weather?
Yeah, Dave. Clear, breezy, and cool this afternoon, high 51. Tonight's low around 32. Mostly sunny and warmer tomorrow, high around 60, low around 35. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
And let's talk to Jake. Hey, Jake.
Dave.
Hey, Jake.
What is this, Dave?
Jake, this is called, I don't know, Jake, this is talking about improving our way of life,
Dave,
Jake.
You were talking about life like it's an episode of the Jetsons or something. You can't work 10 hours a week. Where were you born, Dave?
No, Jake, you can work 10 hours a week. If we set up a society that would work, we could set it up, Jake.
This is like a bunch of
Jake,
kindergartners deciding.
Oh, gosh, Jake.
This is like a bunch of kindergartens, Dave, deciding on what finger paint to use. What is going on here?
You work 40 hours a week, unless you're a bum. You work 40 hours a week.
And you should, Dave.
And for 40 hours a week, I think I should make $10,000 a week. That is an enormous amount.
Let me put this in terms you can understand,
No, that is
Dave.
Enormous amount of time.
Here's something right on your wavelength,
no,
Dave.
If I make 40 hours worth of potato salad and baked beans, and you make 40
Dave,
hours worth of baked beans and potato
to.
Salad.
This is me you're talking to. You don't have to explain this. Right. I'm not one of your regular normal callers. I understand,
all right,
Dave.
All right, go ahead, Jay.
Dave, let me put this in terms you can understand, okay?
All right.
People are sheep, right? What does a sheep need, Dave? They need a sheep herder.
Right.
That's what you people need is a bunch of sheep. It's sheep herders. That's what the government is. They're sheep herders. They herd you people. You people, I mean, it's like a Boy Scout helping an old lady across the street. That's what you need, Dave. That is what this country needs. And that's what it's getting, and you people are complaining about it. You're lucky you got a roof over your head,
Dave.
So
we need a dictator, right? We need a dictator.
You need somebody to tell you what to do, Dave, because you're incapable of doing it. That is the bottom line, Dave.
No, I want more time to do what I want to do, Jake.
Dave, I want a Ferrari, Dave, but I can't get it. You've got to follow orders, Dave, okay?
No.
Dave, all right, I have never the stupidest call of the day, Dave. This is bar none the dumbest call I have ever heard in my life. This shows you right here what your
call
is.
Your call? What?
No. That's cute, Dave.
Yeah.
All right, Kathy, talking about how all we need to do is just print up money. And solve the. Did she just wake up from hibernation or something? You can't print money and solve all the problems.
No.
This country has to be ran by a system, Dave. You cannot just print money and make everybody rich. I mean, you people are watching Gilligan's Island or something. What is going on? Do you not understand
the
system?
Did you hear the analogy earlier? The shack is built. We've built the country. We've built everything we need. The shack is built. Now it's time to sit back, get myself a coconut, and mess around with Marianne. That's what life should be all about. Give me my 2 hours a day that I can contribute, and then I should live like a king.
Dave.
And so should you. And I'm telling you, we are smart enough people, we could do it. Yes.
Why does Jake sound like a cross between Richard and Mark?
Jake, you sound like a cross between Richard and Mark. I don't know why.
It's like some kind of mutant of the two.
Melanie, are you doing your job right now? Get back and answer calls. You're not doing your job. What are you doing, Melanie?
Yes, sir,
Jake. Are you the co-host?
Right away, Jake.
All right,
off the line, Melanie. I'm talking to
you. All right, Jake. Thanks for the call,
Yeah,
Jake.
Whatever, Dave.
Bye, Jake.
Yeah.
Let's go to Lance. Hey, Lance, you're on AM 750 WSB.
What's happening, Dave?
Lance, I'm trying to straighten out this city we call Atlanta.
I'll tell you what. You need to take people like Jake and shove the system up their rear end. That's the problem.
Yeah.
That is the problem.
Yeah, well, see,
it's the system that's the problem.
No, but see, the system was set up to work for you and I. It is an employee. It is a tool we have set up to do a job for us. But the system is out of control.
The system is screwed.
The system. So, but see, the system, I wouldn't have a problem tomorrow with ripping up every paper connected with the system and starting over from scratch.
Well, let's do it. We just need somebody with the guts to get out there and do it.
Because that does not change you or I. It means we've set up a new management team. You walk into a business. If the business is losing money and it's screwed from the top down, what do? You throw out all the top management, all the top employees, and you get a new staff in there, a new group of people.
That's right. That's what needs to be done with the United States government right now.
Yes, it does. Take every single one of them out and just get rid of them.
It needs to be just thrown totally out the door, start a new slate, get some good folks in there.
Did you agree with the guy earlier? He says, we could do away with Congress.
That's right.
The third branch of government could be you and I.
That's right. There's just more money going out the door to folks who think they know how to write the law.
I mean, what you don't understand, these bums like, Newt and people like this, they're making enormous amounts of money. They just wrote themselves a big pay raise, right?
Yes.
Plus, they have a congressional staff of $500,000 a year, offices and stuff like that. Each one of these guys is blowing $1 million a year of your money.
That's right. Well, look at Howell Heflin. He's been in Alabama for, over 30 years just sitting there. I mean, he can barely get his chin up off of his chest.
The third branch of government should be you and I with a little remote control box in our hand, and we vote on issues every single night at 8 o'clock.
Exactly.
Every Friday night, we'll all meet in front of the TV set, and let's decide if Congress should get a pay raise.
I'll tell you what, like I said, somebody needs to get the guts up to do it and run for office, and by golly, I think they'll go through it.
Yeah, but see, you can't run for an office of a system that doesn't work.
I know, but
it's kind of goofy to say, all right, you're going to run for Congress in a system that does not work. You can't do that. You have to say we have to cancel out the system entirely and rewrite the system.
Well, why don't we just drop the bomb on Washington?
No. Well, see, we're smarter than the people of 200 years ago that existed. We are smarter than they are.
Yeah.
We could write a better system. We could correct all the flaws.
How do we do it?
We are a more educated group of people. I don't know, Lance. You tell me. If I knew, I'd do it. I have no idea.
You're on the right track, though, bud.
I have no idea, Lance. See you later, Lance.
See you, man.
I wish I knew how. I have no idea. Sam, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Dave Paul.
Sam.
I am going to improve my way of life in the next couple of days. I sold all my hogs.
You did.
And I'm flying to Cancun, Mexico for 3 days.
Wow.
And I'm going to spend about a week in the Grand Bahama Islands.
Put it all on black, man. Put even or odd on the roulette wheel and double your money.
I have one friend that's going with me, and I need about 10 more.
Get it? Oh.
Females.
10 more, yes.
Yeah, tell them to call in there.
Call in. Go to Bahamas. Your treat, right, Sam?
My treat.
All right, Sam.
Bye. Merry Christmas.
Now, Merry Christmas to you. Steven, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Two comments for you today.
Okay.
Number one is there's an old ancient proverb that says, consider the ant you sluggard. Anybody that's going to work 10 hours a day, if you have another group of people that works 20 hours a day doing the same thing, they're going to be more efficient. Number two comment is that this whole thing was tried before for 75 years in a nation on the earth called the Soviet Union, and look how inefficient they were. You can revamp the government, but hard work is what makes things run, whether you're an employer or an employee. That's all I have to make.
Hard work. Thank you. But hard work, regardless of the time. 10 hours a week is hard work. John, you're on AM 750 WSB.
David.
John.
How are you?
Good.
David, I've got this figured out.
All right.
Hey, think of all the people that used to have to work hard and do labor, and now they've got robots and computers doing the work.
That's right.
And the labor.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, people that used to make $600 a week, they're laid off. Now they got people out there making $300. They're replacing those jobs with jobs where they're making $300 a week.
Right.
You're right. They got to work 50 hours a week instead of 40 ends meet.
We're slaves, economic slaves.
I see a problem, though.
What's the problem, John?
There's a problem.
What is it?
What happens when they run out of raw materials to make these widgets with?
Then we won't have no more widgets.
That's right.
See you, John.
We'll only have enough materials to make a certain amount of widgets.
Okay. Gotta go,
who gets
John.
The widgets? Me? I want the widgets.
I'm history, John. I've gotta go. I'm history, man. Dave Paul, AM 750. Bye. See you later.